Saying, can you hear me? Everybody else did, so I did. Just before I pray, Wednesday night, I will be speaking on the greatest friend you ever had. You may think you know who it is, but you may not. Would you stand with me, please? Lord, we just thank you today. Lord, we are humbled when we realize how good you have been to us. And Lord, what we have today, you have been so gracious to give us and even preparing us to receive it. We bless you today, Lord. And as we begin this service, we want to say thank you. And like the children of Israel, when they had reached a certain point, they set up a stone and said, Eben Ezer, hitherto hath the Lord brought us. And Lord, you have brought us to this point. You have given us these facilities. And Lord, we honor you and praise you today for all these things which you have so graciously bestowed upon us. And Lord, we think now as we continue in this service, we ask for your blessing. We know you will bless us, Lord. We have come to receive a blessing, but we've come also to bless you, Lord, and to praise you and to thank you. Lord, we have so far to go. Even our best efforts are not good enough. But Lord, what you anoint with your Spirit becomes precious in your sight. We ask you to anoint with your Spirit the things that are done through this day as we dedicate this building to you, Lord. And Lord, protect us in the future that we do not fall into the trap of worshiping the building and forgetting the one who sanctifies it. And now, and Lord, now we offer unto thee this thanksgiving and this prayer as we begin this service today. This is found in 1 Chronicles. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee, and thou reignest over all. And in thine hand is power and might, and in thine hand it is to make great and to give strength unto all. Now, therefore, our God, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name. Amen. Amen.
Let's go to key of E. We're going to do Let the River Flow. Hallelujah. Say, I'm too blessed to be stressed. Boy, that was weak. I'm too blessed to be stressed.
Too blessed to be stressed.
Okay. We're going to sing this Let the River Flow as the offering is taken. Praise his name. Hallelujah.
Let the poor man say,
know, we never greet each other, so why don't we stand? We're going to sing. See, this is the day. This is the day of dedication of this new facility. Hallelujah. Are you excited?
Amen.
Half of you are excited.
Amen.
Are you excited?
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah. We're going to do this is the day because that is the day right now.
Amen.
Get up and shake hands with somebody, even Jerry Castle. Just shake hands with him. No, you do it. Let's do it.
This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And be glad in it. This is.
Holy name. Hallelujah. You know, I don't see Todd Bogue here. Am I missing him?
Right behind you.
Hi, Todd. I want a hug.
How we doing this morning? Everybody doing good? Are we ready for the celebration?
Amen.
Amen. Isn't God good today?
Yes.
Go ahead, dear. I'm gonna get
excited. Praise his name. Hallelujah. Give the God a big, big hand. Jack, come on up here.
Hallelujah. What a day that'll be.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Dedication.
Amen.
Good to be here. Jerry, you got your hearing aids up? Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, man. I know. Okay, Gary. Dark valley, no hope within could I see. Then they searched through heaven and found a stranger who saved a poor lost soul like me.
Oh, what a Savior.
The waters I'll soon be crossing. His hand will lead me safe o'er. Then I'll join the chorus
service, dear God, but what we really thank you for, dear God, is for
for being our Savior, dear God, for being our healer. Father, for just ministering to us, dear God, and directing our steps. Thank you, Lord, for your precious blood, dear God. Father, we ask you just keep your Holy Spirit within this whole congregation. If there's needs out there, dear God, which there always is needs, dear God, whether it be our friends that are lost, dear God, we ask you to send your Spirit to them, and we ask you to draw them like you drew us. Oh, thank you for the drawing of us. We praise you, dear God, that we have you that will draw the people unto you, dear God, that are so special to us. We thank you for being a healer, dear God. We ask you, dear God, for anybody that feels like they need some kind of prayer, you come forward, dear God, whenever you want to. We ask you to pull them with your Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and we believe and we love. And everybody said,
amen.
Again, they said, come on out, Sucker. I fell in love with my own wife. Did anybody else? Don't you fall in love with my wife. I mean your own wife. You did? Yeah.
It's about time after 51 years, don't you think? This is a brand new song, and I'm like Dawn. I get nervous when something new comes up, but I love the message in the song. In the book of Acts, it tells us we are to go out to the highways and byways and share the Lord. How are they going to know unless we go? And revival in the land is today's, this month, and hopefully forever, the call of Indiana, Revive Indiana. This is called Wake the Land, and that's what it's talking about. It's going to the highways and byways, sharing the love and the Lord and the healing and the restoration of the Lord. So we'll see if we can do it.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Thank you so much. Man, I taught that little part in there, the growl. I taught Paige to do that.
Don't be laughing. It could have happened.
Yeah, but whenever you taught her how to do it, it was in anger.
Oh, it was in anger.
Yes.
Hey, Jan, come and sing this song that I'm so happy to hear. Jan has had a little accident last week, but get a couple ribs real bad, and yeah. But and I asked her, I called her because I really wanted her to sing this song so much, and she loves the Lord so much, and she couldn't do it. And then all at once she called me, and she said with a whole bunch of dope, no, with some pain pills. But she said that she'd be glad to, and we love you, Jan.
I'm glad Larry asked for the song. First time I ever heard this song, I was visiting in another church. And when the gentleman got up and sang it, I said, God, I want to sing this song for you because it's my heart to you. So if you listen to the words, it has to be the heart of every Christian.
Sometimes just to speak your name.
Speak your name.
And sometimes I just want to thank you.
I mean, he blesses us every day. And the songs that's been sung this morning, I'm just so thankful for. They've been beautiful. I love Jack's song. And the little perky song that Todd done, which got us going and got us started. We're here to praise him. We're here to worship him. We're here to lift him up. And we need to get excited about this man called Jesus and what he's done for us.
Thank you so much, Jan. Hallelujah. I have no idea, Paige, where I am on this.
Oh,
now I see it. Yeah, now I see it. Calvary's the reason why. Jesus Christ is the reason why. Give him a hand. Hallelujah. Praise his name. You know, this church, Brad and everybody gave so much to Paige and I to minister. We've ministered in many different ways, whether it be in the prisons and jails and Kokomo Rescue Mission. And then we started going to the nursing homes and they wanted to keep me, so I quit. I just didn't want to stay there. But we appreciate you so much and we want to thank you for contributing to our life and allowing us to worship with you and be somewhat kind of a leader. But I don't want to lead. I want this guy up here to lead. Give him one more hand, will you please? Jimmy?
Go ahead. It is deep as it is wide. You know all our hopes, Lord, you know all our fears. Words cannot express the love we feel, but we long for you to hear. So listen to our hearts, hear our spirits sing a song of praise that blows for those you have redeemed, and we will use the word. tell you of our love, so listen to our hearts.
Okay.
Words could fall like rain from these lips of mine. And if I had 1,000 years, I would still run out of time. So if you listen to my heart, every beat would say, thank you for the truth, thank you for the light, thank you for the way. So listen to our hearts, hear our spirits sing a song of praise that flows for those you have redeemed. And we will use the words we know to tell you what an awesome God you are. When words are not enough to tell you of our love, listen to our hearts. Aren't you thankful that he hears our hearts? You know all our hopes, Lord, you know all our fears. Words cannot express the love we feel, but we long for you to hear. So listen to our hearts, hear our spirits sing a song of praise that flows for those you have redeemed. Words we know to tell you what an awesome God you are. When words are not enough to tell you of our love, so listen to our hearts. When words are not enough to tell you of our love, so listen to our hearts.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I don't know if you know how God gave Jimmy to us, but it was several years ago. That was a new song that he sang. And God has given him a talent on the guitar that is just wonderful. Yes, absolutely. Jimmy, we like you. Todd, you have no talent whatsoever when it comes to anything. Give God, Todd, a hand. We got to applaud everything. Hallelujah. Are you glad to have Albert back?
Yes.
Michelle, are you coming up? Yes. Yes, please.
You know, this is the day the Lord has made, and we're to rejoice and be glad in it. God's working today. We've come into this house this morning to praise him and to lift him up and to glorify him. And he's got things to do today, and he's already done some of them up here. But if you're sitting out there today and you feel a tug at your heart, that's Jesus saying, come to me. And all you have to do is come down to this altar. We'd be more than glad to pray for you. And if you're here and you're in a backslidden condition and you feel God touching you, this morning is today. Today is the day of salvation. And he'll restore you. And if you've got a sickness in your body today, God will take care of that also, because he's an almighty God and he can do anything that he wants to that pleases him. But I'll tell you what, you have to be obedient to him. So if you're here this morning and God is touching you, you feel that touch and you need that prayer, please, not for me, not for Brad or anybody in this room, but for the Lord Jesus Christ, obey that call.
Thank you, Gene. Thank you.
I just feel led to read a verse or a passage. It says, "Praise ye the Lord."
Give her that. There you go.
I said I feel just led to read a verse or a chapter in Psalms. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His firmament of His power. Praise Him according to His mighty works. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. Praise Him with sound of the trumpet. Praise Him with psaltery and with harp. I can't hardly say this without shouting. I'm not kidding you. It's just... Praise Him with timbrel and dance. Praise Him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise Him upon loud cymbals. Praise Him upon high-sounding cymbals. Let everything that hath breath, that's you.
Amen.
Everything that has breath, praise Him. And I'm telling you, if you're born again, you're not going to be able to sit in those seats without praising the Lord, because Amen. This, Amen. Although this is beautiful, oh, how God has blessed you. This is nothing compared to the greatness that we're going to have in heaven one day. So we may as well just stand up and practice, because we're going to be shouting all the way to glory if you're going.
Amen.
And I have to say, I was born and raised in General Baptist, and that's my roots. And oh my, just to see the way things have evolved and the way that things that God has blessed you is just wonderful. And I'm glad to be a part of this day. And I thank Brad and Albert for inviting me to be here. So I love you all, and I'm so happy for what God's doing for you and through you. And as far as you, this is just a season in your life. God's got another season preparing for you. It's the beginning for you. And I know that. I feel God's anointing on you. And Todd, for whatever reason, I feel like God is telling me to say to you, give them perfect peace for him who trusts him. Because you do trust him. I don't know what you're going through. And when God was telling me to tell you that, I was like, Lord, please, I don't want to say anything out of turn. But I just feel like I need to tell you that. He's got it.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad to be in the house today with the Lord? Praise God. Well, we're going to do the one y'all like. Holding up the ladder. Go ahead, Dad. You're in mind. There's a mansion being
built for me somewhere, glory land. And this ladder that I climb is a part of the plan. I can hear the angels beckoning, keep climbing, don't stop. There's a crown of life awaiting for you when you reach the top. Show the world your life can shine. Get on this gospel ladder and don't be afraid to climb. Can't you hear the angels cheering? Soon the battle will be o'er, and we'll celebrate this victory when we reach the other shore. They're holding up the ladder that I'm climbing on. I'm climbing up the ladder and I'm going home at the top of. At the top of the ladder, oh what joy there will be, for the angels are holding up this ladder for me. They're holding up the ladder that I'm climbing on. I'm climbing up the ladder and I'm going home at the top of the ladder. Oh what joy there will be, for the angels are holding up this ladder for me. Yes, the angels are holding up this ladder for me.
You got to get in that Martin Luther King.
You got it? All right, this is a new one. We've done it before, but still new, and it was one that God gave me here about a couple years ago, and it's titled Get Out of the Boat.
Out of that boat and walk in his righteousness.
out of that bone, and he will make you free. Storms of life are raging, and it seems hard to bear. Everything around us, there's trouble everywhere. Sometimes we get discouraged, and we just don't know what to do. But thank you, Lord, for Jesus, who walks this road with you. Get out of that boat, says the Lord Jesus. Get out of that boat and come unto me. Get out of that boat and walk in his righteousness. Get out of that bone, and he will make you free. Get out of that bone. Get out of that bone. Get out of that bone, and he will make you free.
Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Jack Ebenhart, now you see why I love this church. Amen. Hallelujah. Boy, I'll tell you, you'll be blessed by Jack, too, this afternoon. What a talented man that God gave us for this dedication service, too. Give Jack a big hand, if you would, please. Rick, could you come up?
Only thing I got to say is praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for everything you've done. I come to this church to praise God. The Word is good, that I can read the Word myself. But I like to be with you and in worship and praise to my Savior that died for my sins. So I just praise him. Go ahead, Gary.
Here we are in your presence, lifting holy hands to you. Here we are, praising Jesus for the things he's brought us through. Love and took me in.
Yes, please. Yes.
Before we sing, I want to share about Revive Indiana. There was we had teams that went out yesterday morning, and really, it was really a good turnout considering it wasn't greatly advertised, but we had 14 teams that went out yesterday morning, of four, groups of four.
Wow. Yeah.
And we hit the community, and I think when all was done, there were three or four brand new souls saved.
Got a hand
on the streets. Hallelujah. God is alive, and that's what he's called us to do, to go out and love people and just to love on them. And that's what we're doing. And that's, you'll know, if you want to know more about this, come Wednesday night in June. We're going to educate you and share some more about what's happening in Kokomo and what we're doing. And it's so important because God has called us to go out. And then you know what happens? Their lives change. And guess what? They're looking for a church with somebody to love on them more and more. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise God. You listen to the words of this song.
I'd like to share something too. Gary, if you could turn this up a little bit. As I sing, my voice gets weaker. But this first song is called I'm Not Giving Up. And I've had to practice that for the last 2.5 years. I've had 5 surgeries in 2.5 years, been on liquid chemo for a year. They put me on some chemo pills. They wanted me to take them for 5 years, but every one that they give me locks up my muscles. It just destroys me in my jaws and neck, ribs, pelvic, back, legs, ankles, everywhere. So I can't take those, but I can take Jesus.
Amen.
No. Doctors are awesome, but they're only practicing physicians. And when you do what you're supposed to do and they tell you what you're supposed to do, do it. But if that fails, Jesus is the great physician.
Yes, he is. Amen.
So Amen. Don't give up.
Yes, he is. Don't give
okay?
up.
Okay? And with me, there's no fear. A lot of people say there's fear with cancer. It was cancer, breast cancer. There's no fear with me, never has been. The fear was of the chemo, because I saw what I did to my brother. But I thought, well, Lord, if you're setting me up for chemo, I'll do what you want me to do. I'll take it. And you know what my body takes and what it doesn't.
Amen.
And if it doesn't take it, there's you.
Yes.
You know, there's still him with it, okay? So I don't doubt that in the least. And another thing, I've had a lot of people ask me about why Larry and I are stepping down. It's time for somebody else, and the Lord's told us that. It's not because we're this, that, or the other. To remove fear factors, we're going to be here. We're still going to be singing in groups with Brad and Sandra, and there's still things with the Lord for us to do, like Michelle said. You know, your ministries don't give up and go away. They just go on in a different direction. So it's not a problem with us. We just all fear change. And we have to give people a chance to come in. If they don't fit, we'll know it and they'll know it. That's not a problem. Mm-hmm. You know, but God's got somebody out there
Amen.
To take us another 10, 15 years. And then after that, there'll be somebody else that'll come in to take us another 10 or 15 years. We just have to go on in Jesus in the way we're supposed to go. So I want you to know that Larry and I are at peace with it. We know that the Lord wants us to step down and he's got somebody else to step up. But we're going to be here to help.
Amen.
Our job's not done.
Amen.
Jimmy?
Yeah.
We can't give up, Jimmy.
Right.
Let's do it. Go ahead.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
God, I'm gonna win this shiny crown someday.
Well, I'll keep holding on to those nail-scarred hands. I'm not giving up,
no, I'll keep holding on.
Well, I've been walking through the valley.
Yes, come on.
And through this vale of tears. At times I've even questioned, even if my Lord was near. But many times that old tempter says, why not turn around? 'Cause you'll not get any further, because you're just losing ground. But I'm not giving up.
shiny crown someday.
Well, I'll keep
holding on, holding on
to his
nail-scarred hands.
I'm not giving up,
no, I'll keep holding on.
No, well, I'm not giving up, oh, no, and I'm not turning around. By the grace of God, I'm gonna win this shiny crown someday. Well, I'll keep
holding on,
holding on
to his nail-scarred hands.
I'm not giving up,
no, I'll keep holding on.
Amen. And I'll tell you another thing. You can. Thank you. Okay. Well, while she comes up, I wanted to tell you one other thing. Whether I leave this earth with the Lord today, or if I go home and I'm fine, it's a win-win for me. So I'll never be, he'll never fail me in that area.
That song is exactly what I walk every day.
Me too.
Not giving up. I just want to give my testimony for the Lord. Things happen at our house, and it's silly because I live there with Larry. And you know, we have a garden, and we have flower gardens, and we weed. Oh, weed. We weed, and you know, when you're pulling out those weeds with the beautiful flowers around them, sometimes the Lord says that is as we weed out the sin in our lives.
Yes.
And give it to him.
Yes.
Yesterday I was weeding and I had a pail full of weeds. And I walked over to off where our property ends, and it's where we dump the weeds. And I was very shaky and carrying, and the yard is unlevel. And I said, oh Lord, I hope I don't fall over. And I did. And I said, Larry, I fall over, I fall over. So he come and help me up. We can fall over in our walk with the Lord. But scripture says, if you seek me, you will find me.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Amen. And that's what this song is all about. I'm holding on because we're seeking the Lord.
That's right. Hallelujah.
We will find him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, clarinet.
Man. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we're glad you're here, DR, and I know they run that every week, so I don't know what happened there, but we have two drivers, and they run every week, but we're glad you're here, and God's good, isn't he? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
No other name above heaven or earth can you be saved.
Yes.
He paid the price, and we just accept it. It's an easy meal deal. A lot of people try to make it real hard, but he's so good, he doesn't make it hard.
Amen.
Go ahead, Gary.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
There's not much in a name. Some have fortune, some have fame. But this man means so much more to me.
Yes, he does. Thank you, Lord.
Just the mention of his name can crumble mountains to the sea. Oh, there's power in this man, yes. Jesus.
Yes, there is. Thank you, Lord. Aren't you glad?
Jesus, he gave his life for us. Jesus is there whenever I call, and he cares for my every need. Amen, every one of them. When I'm hungry, he feeds me. When I've lost my way, he leads me. Oh, there's power.
Aren't you glad?
In this man, Jesus. Now men worship many things, fancy houses, diamond rings, but none compared to this man, Jesus.
Oh, I like this. Listen now.
For he hung on a cross. He gave his life for a world that was lost.
Listen now.
But he lives today.
How many knows he lives today?
Yes. Yes, this man, Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Jesus, he gave his life for us. Jesus, he's there whenever I call. And he cares for my air and yours too. When I'm hungry, he feeds me. When I've lost my way, he leads me. Oh, there's power in this man, Jesus. Jesus, he gave his life for us. Jesus, he's there whenever I call, and he cares.
I guess we're going to do a third one. Mercy walked in.
Thank you, Lord.
If his wasn't for his mercy, we wouldn't be here.
Yes.
You know, it's not by works. It's by his grace.
I'm thankful one day he saved me. How about you? How many knows what I'm talking about today? Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Long time ago.
Thank you.
He keeps me. Was saved at 13. 14, my brother was killed in an accident. Set me back a couple of years. But God knows how to take control.
Yes, he does.
Brought me back. Been going with him ever since. Thank God. Amen?
Amen.
He's a great God. He's worthy Amen. To be praised. And you listen to the words on Mercy Walked In. I stood in the courtroom The judge turned my way. It looks like you're guilty. Now what do you say? I spoke up, Your Honor. I have no defense. But that's when mercy walked in. Mercy walked in and pleaded my case. Called to the stand, God saving grace. The blood was presented. Born again, the moment mercy walked in. Mercy walked in, pleaded my case, called to the stand. God said,
I just want to say something real quick here. The Bible says that the young men will have visions. It says that the old men will have dreams. This old man had a dream last night. I very seldom ever remember dreams, but this one I can't get rid of. And I was sitting there and I was saying, Lord, what do you want me to do? He says, share what I gave you. I don't know if somebody needs it. But I was someplace, I don't know where. And there was a preacher preaching, and it wasn't Brad or anybody in here. And they were making it so complicated, so hard to understand what we had to do. And in my dream, I jumped up and I said, no. All you have to do is have the faith of a little child. That's all. He said, if you come to me with the faith of a little child, I will give you life ever after. That's all it takes. It's not complicated. You got a neighbor telling me, hey, you don't have to do anything except just believe that he died for you. All you've got to do. Now, why I had this dream, because I believe it. I believe it. But why I had this dream, I don't know. Maybe somebody in here needs it. I don't know. But God's sitting there and says, Rick, I want you to share this. But just remember the faith of just a little child. A little child, you tell your children something, a little child. You tell him that there's a man in the moon, he believes there's a man in the moon because he can see it. He is very easy. A little child is very easy to believe. And that's all Jesus wants us to do, is to believe in him. That's all. That was my dream, so I had to
Thank
share
you, Rick. Thank you so much. I get quite a privilege right now. I have a brother-in-law, Jerry Kuhn. And we was going to be mean to him and tell him to give it a little testimony about a month ago so he could get real nervous about it. But we waited until Thursday afternoon, and we asked him to prepare himself. And we told him we would give him at least, 30, 40 seconds. Jerry and I have enjoyed each other's company for a long, long time. I used to look at him and smile, but now I look at him and laugh out loud a lot of times. That's just because of who he is. Jerry, could you come up at this time? I appreciate it. Give Jerry a big hand. I heard you had a little bit to do with helping in the church, just a little bit, building this, just a little bit.
Not much. I'm not used to being up here. I'm used to being in the back. So you got to be patient with me. Like Larry said, he gave me about 2 days to come up with my testimony. And at first I was going to say no, but, I don't have that big a testimony to give. But I was thinking there's probably 80% of you people out there are the same way I am. You think you don't have a testimony, but you really do. Everybody does. I have to go back quite a ways, but I'm not going to bore you with a lot of things. I come from a family that was not a Christian family. I was the seventh of 10 kids. We lived in a pretty poor neighborhood, probably one of the worst neighborhoods in Kokomo. So, I've got to put this in here, and it doesn't mean a lot, but I was a Dutch. I couldn't speak plain. When I was younger, I was in a rough neighborhood. Very few people could understand me. I wasn't tongue-tied. I wasn't, wasn't mentally. It was just something about it that I couldn't speak very plain. Sondra knows about a lot of those words that I used to say that I'm not going to say. But so I had a little rough childhood. I kind of learned a way out was fighting. I learned to fight. Used to be a gentleman in here named Bob Hedricks. Him and I used to talk about this because Bob had a bad stuttering problem. And we used to talk about it, to how the kids used to pick on us and things like that. But as far as spiritually, I had none. I wasn't involved in church. My family wasn't involved in church. I don't even remember seeing a Bible in our family. The first Bible I ever saw was a little, that I had anyway, was one of those little pocket Bibles that the city used to give out to kids, and had my little name in it, and I think Gideon used to put them out. But that was the only Bible I ever really knew. I fought organized religion. I didn't go to church. I had people ask me to go to church, and I said, no, I wasn't going to do that. I really didn't believe there was a God. I went a long time doing that. Even
when I was in my 40s, Larry and I used to make fun of Paige and Sandra because they went to church, right? And but anyway, during school, I did well in school when I was there. Most of the time I wasn't there because I was fighting. Had to go see the principal and those kind of things. But anyway, with that, I met Sandra. Sandra was a peaceful kind of person, and I wasn't. I don't know how she put up with me for all those years, but she did. We ended up having two great children. The daughter has cystic fibrosis. She wasn't supposed to live through infancy, but she did with God's help. That I know that now, with God's help. I didn't think that way before. I thought it was because Sandra and I took care of her. You know, Sandra, she had to have exercises at least 3 times a day, and most of the time she got 4 and 5 times. So Sandra took care of that. Riley couldn't understand how she made it through infancy. And they said, well, she'll probably never go to school. Well, she went to school. Well, you know, the oldest living cystic fibrosis patient at that time was 21 years old. Well, she wasn't going to live very much longer. Well, she's 40 years old and still doing well. And that's a God's thing. I mean, there wasn't no reason for that to happen. I didn't know that at the time. Believe me, I was still fighting it. And as we go on through life, one of my best friends and drinking buddies, Larry, he got saved. He needed it. I didn't. But he got saved. Sister-in-law married a preacher, Gary Richmond, fine gentleman. They both kept on me, and they wasn't winning the battle. I was still winning. Sunday, Sandra would take the kids to church, and I'd stay in bed, or I'd get up and watch football, or I'd go play golf, or I'd go fishing, or I'd work in the yard. I did have one bad habit. I was a workaholic. Sandra's always had to put up with that. I was always gone or I was always working, but she did. And as time went on, God put me next to a gentleman at a birthday party, Lowell Richmond. And the first thing, he was the oldest one there, and he put me next to him. And it was one of Joe Allen's kid's birthday. And first thing Lowell says to me, he says, where do you go to church? I don't. And don't bother with that because I don't go to church. Your son, Gary, and my brother-in-law, Larry, they've tried it. They've not made it. So let's just not go there with it. Oh, okay. That's fine. So we talked about a lot of other things. And then when I get up to go home, well, it was Sunday afternoon, and all of them had to go back to church. They had to come down. They were going down on First John Baptist. They had to go to church. Well, I went home. So Lowe says, Jerry, do you mind if I try getting you in church? Well, no. I mean, several people have, and you can do it if you want to. Well, the next morning, of course, the kids were all working, and Sandra was working, and I got up to go to work, and I really never had a job. I had to go early, but I got up to go to work, and I look out there, and there's this black Cadillac sitting in my driveway. And I'm thinking, who in the world is that? So I go out, and it's Lowell. And I said, Lowell, what are you doing? He says, I'm praying. I said, praying for what? He said, I'm praying for you. I said, he said, you said it was okay. I said, I did. And he said, yeah, you said I could work to get you in church. I said, oh, well, that's true. I said that was okay. So I went on to work, and he was still there. He was praying. I come home that night, that black Cadillac sitting in my driveway. And I said, hello, what are you doing? He says, I'm praying. I said, you've been here all day? And he said, no. I was on my way home, and I just stopped by here, and I was praying to get, I'm just praying to get you in church. Okay. This happened for a week and a half. Except for Sundays. He went to church on Sundays, bless God, you know. And he did this for at least a week and a half or 2 weeks. I don't know. It was a long time. So I said, I come home one night and I went in the house and I went back out there and I said, Lo, when you get done praying, why don't you come in and have supper? Okay, that'd be great. Yeah. So, and you got to understand Lo, and I know Gene and Sue sitting there laughing, and they know Lo, and Lo was just that way. And well, you know, my daughter was the last one to leave home, but Lo took her place. He was there every night. And he said, and every night we had a Bible study at supper table. And it was great, really. I didn't think so at the time, but it was great, you know. And Lo was a guardian angel. He was sent to get me in church. Here I am now. And I've been here for 20-some years. He told me back then, he said, I've got a plan for you. He said, no, he didn't say I. He said, God's got a plan for you. And you're part of a building that's going to be built. And I said, Lo, I'm not even a member of the church yet. And he said, you will be. And I was. I did. I become a member. Been baptized, saved right here. And in the meantime, he said, the plan is we're going to build on to that church. And you're going to do it. And I said, no, I don't think so. He said, yes, you are. But he didn't tell me one thing. I accepted the job, but Lo didn't tell me that they'd already tried twice to build onto that church and never got it done because it was in a floodplain. Nobody told me that until I went up to the county and I run into this not such a nice guy, but he had a pigtail, and I can't even think of his name. But he says, you can't build onto that church because it's in a floodplain. And then he proceeded to say, you're lying to that congregation. And I had a temper. I mean, I used to have a temper, and I used to be a fighter. And I said, I wanted to reach across that thing, grab him by the pigtail, and shake him a few times. But Lo says, no, Jerry. No, that ain't the way it works. No. He doesn't know who he's messing with. He's messing with God. And he says, we'll get that. And he said, I doubt whether you'll get it through me. Well, there's got to be somebody else. And then he made a stupid statement. He said, if you can get the state to okay it, I'll okay it. So Lo and I took off for the state. The state approved it. We brought it back and took it to him, and he said, well, I can't approve that. I said, you said if the state approved it, you would approve it. He said, I still can't approve it. It's got to go through the county. And it's still in a floodplain, and the county commissioners are not going to okay that. Guess what happened? We had a flood. We did have a flood. We had a 100-year flood, didn't we? What they consider a 100-year flood. It never got to the building. the county commissioners had to say, we can't deny it because the water never got to the building. And it's a 100-year flood. I had that headlines out of the newspaper, and I took it up there and set it on their desk, and I said, look at that. And the county commissioner said, no, we can't deny it. You've got to let them build on. And at the same time, we came down here to buy this land. I think Larry, you proposed the fact that we come down here on this corner. They were having I want to back up just a minute. Lo and I went and talked to the lady about buying this land, and she said, nope, it's not for sale. It's not for sale. And so if you wanted to buy it, you had to buy all, I think it was 700 acres or whatever it was, and we couldn't afford 700 acres. So we said, okay. But then she got in tax problems, and they had to auction it off, and so we had a meeting, and Larry said, why don't we just go and offer them $70,000 for the 10 acres, the corner lot. I said, nah, they ain't going to take it, but we'll go offer it. So Don Simmons and I went down to the auction, and the bidding went crazy. And I said, Don, he was doing the bidding. I said, just offer him our $70,000 and we'll go home. He did, and not another mouth popped up. Not one other mouth popped up. God shut him up. We not only built onto that building and bought this land at the same time and had a 15-year mortgage, and the church paid it off in 4 years. That is what God can do. That's what God did on it. We decided to build that building over there, which was great because we needed a place to eat. We were running out of room. And Baptists like to eat, so we were running out of room. And basically, that's why we built it. I mean, they want to say it was for the youth, but it was for us to eat. And we built that, and we waited too long. I personally, this is my own personal feeling about it all, is that we waited too long to build this building here, and God come along and flooded that building. He flooded it. He did not destroy it. He could have destroyed that building, but he did not destroy it. He didn't even run the air conditioners, and they were flooded all the way up, all the way up. The furnaces took right off after the water was left. There was no problem there. It was all taken care of. That was only through God did that. He wanted us to move on. He had a plan for us. He had a plan for all of us. He had a plan for me. He had a plan for everyone in this room. All the workers that worked on this building. He had a plan for it. And here we are. It's a beautiful building. Yes, I had a little bit to do with it, but God had the most to do with it. God did it all. AC was with me just about every day. Bless his heart and his John 14. I couldn't have made it through without John 14, because there's a lot of times my heart wasn't whatever. But we made it. We got a beautiful building here. What we need now, we need more Lowell Richmonds to go out and pray in somebody's driveway. And that's what's going to fill this place. I look out here now, I can tell you there's 285 chairs in here. And there's not a lot of empty seats. But we can do a lot better. I'd like to see this place with, we could put 350 in here. Couldn't we? We could put 350 in here, and it'd still be comfortable, and I'd like to see that happen on it. This is just a building unless you got the people in it. Then it's a church. And that's what God wants. He wants to, you know, my testimony is only to the point that I did not believe in God until Lowell Richmond was sent to take care of that. He knew what the plan was. Lowell knew what the plan was. I don't know how he knew it or what it was, but he knew that we were going to do something that was going to turn this church around. And this church has been turned around, and my God, people, there's a lot more of us now than there used to be. And there's going to be a lot more than there is now. Thank you.
Stay right there.
Stay right here. AC Hill, come on down, will you? I need you to come up here right now. Come on, AC.
Don't let your heart be troubled.
You got to, yes, yes.
He was the first one to make a sermon from here, you know that? AC was the first one to make a sermon from here.
Make a sermon.
John 14,
yeah. You know, before we close and get ready to go eat, and we'll come back to the dedication. I just, first of all, want to thank everybody. That includes everybody in here for praying and for being a part of what took place in here. We've had people to come and volunteer and work. Many people stained the ceiling. Remember that? How many remember that? I was here.
86
boards. Yeah, we stained that. People came in together. We had 20 to 25 people come in together at a time in shifts, and we stained every board. And there were others that came in during the week helping Jerry and AC out. But AC was Jerry's sidekick, and he was here. And Jerry, on behalf of AC, on behalf of the church, I want to give you this as a gift of appreciation for you and what you've done here for us. And Jerry, this is your gift also, but I ain't done with you yet. Only by the grace of God. Amen. From the church, Jerry, it says, our hearts felt thanks to Jerry Kuhn for your service to the Lord as our lead contractor for In His Image Worship Center. And the verse is 1 Corinthians 1:4. I thank my God always concerning you for the grace of God which was given to you by Christ Jesus. May 17, 2015. You know, I'm thankful Lowe never give up. I knew Lowe very well, too. He dragged me out of the office a lot of mornings, said, hey, come have breakfast with me. I'm buying. You're going. Lowe got me out in the community. Lowe got me in places, and it really got me started, kick-started back in as I came to Kokomo, and he's quite a guy. But sometimes I would call him, and he'd have an answer machine, and it said, only by the grace of God I'm talking to you. And only by the grace of God you're talking to me. So your message is important. Please leave it. The answer machine. And only by the grace of God, Jerry, it got done, didn't it?
Amen.
I want to give you this, brother. God bless you. Bless you, AC.
I just want everybody to know that I didn't do all this. You know, God did it, and the people in the church did it. AC and Leland and Dan and Jack and all these people that showed up and did it. I can't name them all, and I would miss them if I did. But that's the only reason I would accept this is in their honor, too, because I couldn't have done it by myself. And it was with God's help.
We're doing together what we can't do alone, right? And
But he did all the paperwork. He made sure everything was from the other people was coming in, and I just thank the Lord. And I thank the Lord for you. And we're gonna leave here so we can go and eat. We're really running behind. But that's okay. We're gonna eat and then we're gonna come back. Sheila, do you wanna hand these out over there? Come here a minute. Come here real quick. Real quick, we gotta close in prayer. Sheila, how many members when we broke ground? We broke ground, it was October, right? October? October 13, 2013, and when we broke the ground, Sheila demanded those trustees, I want that dirt. Now you listen.
Well, I'm gonna back up just a little. Jerry mentioned our fellowship hall down here. How many were here before that fellowship hall was built? Do you remember having dinners in that building? We sat everywhere we possibly could, in the hallways, in the nursery, any place. And like Jerry said, they kept saying, never happened, never happened. You're never gonna build there. Do you ever think God sits back and laughs at us? Because we say, I'm never gonna do that. Let me tell you, when I was 18, I said I was never gonna marry a preacher. So, be careful what you say. When we had that groundbreaking there, somebody took the ground and bagged it up, and I have had that little bag of dirt sitting on my shelf for 16 years. I look at it, every time I clean, I have to move it, so it reminds me of what God has done. So when they shoveled that dirt before we built, before we started, before anything was done, I said, I want that dirt. Well, it's been sitting in my garage for a year and a half. But we've got it all bagged up into little bags, and we will pass them out sometime. I'm not sure. Sometime today. Oh, as they go out here?
Yeah, as they go to lunch, we'll
get it. Okay, as you go to lunch. Just a little bag. You can hold it in your pocket. We didn't have a whole lot of dirt in one little spade, but there's enough for everybody to have one for their family. So grab one as you go.
So we're gonna close this part of the service, and then we're gonna have you head over, and probably the best way, just go out the back door here. Sheila and I will try to get over there as we dismiss. We'll have those bags ready, and then you can just, one per family, grab one of those if you'd like, and it has the date on there of the groundbreaking and that dirt. And it's ziplocked, and you can have that, okay? So let's close this part of the service. Jordan, would you come? I appreciate Jordan. This is unrehearsed. Amen. Jordan Stepney came on board about almost a year ago in June, and as our youth leaders, and I appreciate him very much. I'm going to ask him to close this part of the service in prayer, and then we'll go straight over and find a seat. We'll have prayer, and we'll get things going for the dinner, all righty? Okay.
Please pray with me. Father God, we come this morning just in awe of everything that you've done over the years, just the testimonies that have been given, the songs that have been sang, it all points to you. The dreams that have been dreamt years ago and even just last night, it all points to you for this purpose, this very day you've been planning for. Some people were part of that plan, they're not here today, and Lord, we know they're with you, and we're going to see them sometime. So Lord, as we go over to this meal, may you bless it to nourish our bodies so we can go out and better serve you every day. May we look at that little bag of dirt and remember. It's all about remembering just what your son did on the cross. It's what he did on the cross led to this moment, led to that dirt being turned. So Lord, we just lift you up and we praise you, and it's in your name. Amen.